Hey everybody, it's Robin and welcome to my channel where today I have this fun and easy Fortnite cake to share with all of you, and with a few tips and some simple decorations, you guys can make your very own epic Fortnite cake as well. So let's get right into it. So for today's cake, we're going to be starting out with three delicious 8-inch chocolate cake layers, which I'm going to begin by leveling out so that way our cake stacks up nice and straight and level as well. And we're just going to set these scraps off to the side and clean up our crumbs so we can start stacking and filling. So we're going to begin by attaching our first layer of cake to our 10-inch cake board using a little bit of buttercream to act as a glue. And then we're going to take that same buttercream, and this is the chocolate American buttercream. And we're just going to add a nice thick layer in between each of our cake layers. And you can find a link to my easy American buttercream recipe in the description box below. Mind you, it is a vanilla recipe, but by adding a little bit of cocoa and adjusting the liquid content, it makes a beautiful chocolate buttercream as well. So now that we've finished stacking and filling these layers, we're going to go ahead and seal in all these crumbs using a nice thin layer of frosting, also known as a crumb coat. And what this is going to do is help keep that outer layer of icing nice and clean when we add it later on. And now we're going to go ahead and pop our cake into the fridge to firm up while we work on some decorations. So as you guys can see, I've went ahead and created this cool Fortnite logo stencil, and we're going to use this to create a logo out of fondant. So starting with a piece of black fondant first, I'm going to roll this out to approximately 1/8 of an inch thick. Then we're going to place our stencil onto our fondant and use that to mark off our design. But we're not going to start cutting this out right away. We're going to actually place it on a piece of parchment paper and allow it some time to dry, so that way our fondant firms up a little bit when it comes time to cut it later on. And now we're just going to repeat that process with some white for the letters, and we're going to set that off to the side to dry as well. So next up, we're going to be making a big blue flag banner for the top of our cake. Now, I hadn't made one of these before, but it was actually pretty simple, and it created such a nice focal point, as well as being a really nice way to personalize the cake. So as you guys can see, I started off with a piece of blue fondant rolled out to about 1/8 of an inch thick. I used my stencil to mark off the pattern, and then I just cut out my little flag shapes that I needed. So now we're going to take another piece of blue fondant rolled out slightly thicker, lay a flower wire on top of it, and then press it down inside a little bit. Then we're going to take all those little flag shapes and lay them strategically across the wire and cut away any excess fondant we don't need. And I think that looks pretty great so far. We just need to add the birthday boy's name. So using a piece of white fondant rolled out really thin this time, we're taking our stencil, marking off our pattern like we did before, and using the X-Acto knife to cut out all the little pieces and sticking them into place. And I've also wrapped two dowels in fondant, which we're going to use to attach this to the cake. So while we were making our blue flag banner, that gave the fondant for our logo time to firm up nicely. So now we can start cutting. And we're going to start by removing all the little center pieces first, like the inside of the O and the inside of the R. Now, the reason for this is because while you're cutting, it's pulling on the fondant a little bit and it's going to be stretching. And if you have the letter cut out and then you're trying to cut out the center, then you risk the chance of getting it all full of fingerprints and stretching it out and making it look all wonky. So I recommend cutting the inside of your letters first and then work on the outside, so that way you don't have any fondant stretching. And now I'm placing the letters, as you guys can see. Because of the use of our stencil, we were able to see exactly where the letters had to go, so everything lined up perfectly. So now we're going to begin working on the outside of our logo, and this is where things get a little bit tricky. As I said before, when cutting fondant, because of its thickness, there can be quite a bit of pulling, so I highly recommend working in very small sections and cutting those tiny little pieces away as you go to prevent the fondant from stretching. So with a bit of time and practice, I'm confident you guys are going to be mastering this technique in no time. And now that we have our logo finished, we're just going to set this off to the side. But if you guys are making this ahead of time, you're going to want to keep it airtight because it needs to be flexible to attach to the side of the cake. So we're just going to jump back to our cake really quickly and give it another coat of frosting, because we actually have a couple of layers to add and they need to be refrigerated in between each one to prevent any color blending. So using a piping bag, I'm just applying a nice thick layer of that same blue buttercream that I used before, and now using a small offset spatula, I'm just kind of spreading it around to ensure a nice even coverage, and then we're switching over to our bench scraper to smooth it all out. So we're just gonna keep going around and around, wiping our bench scraper off between every pass until we're happy with how that looks. And then we're gonna finish it off by carefully dragging our bench scraper on a slight angle towards the center and pulling that buttercream away until the whole top is nice and smooth and our edges are nice and sharp. And now we're just gonna pop that cake back into the fridge and we can get back to some decorations. So for this next one, we're gonna make a cool ladder for the side of our cake. So starting with a nice big piece of brown fondant, which I rolled out fairly thick, I'm using my Dresden veining tool to create a wood-like pattern all over the fondant. And then we're gonna cut it into nice big strips, which we need two for the length of the ladder. Then we're gonna cut about six of them for the steps. And now we're gonna take all these strips and I'm gonna set them on a piece of parchment paper and then stick it in my food dehydrator for about an hour to allow it to firm up completely. Or if you don't have one, you can also place it in your oven for a few hours with just the light on, as that also works quite sufficiently. All right, so next up, we're gonna start making the types of things you would go looking for in the game, such as a med pack and some bandages. So for the med pack, I just cut out a big chunky rectangle piece of white fondant. And for the bandages, I've rolled out a big long snake shape that I'm gonna cut into a bunch of equal segments. So next I'm gonna roll out a long strip of red fondant, and this is rolled out really thin, and we're just gonna cut a great big thick piece to go around our med pack. And then I'm gonna cut some smaller, thinner ones to go around all of the bandages. So the bandages are done, but we have one more thing left to do to our med pack, and that's cut out a little tiny white cross to go on the top. And voila, our med pack and our bandages are all done. So next up, we are gonna make some shield potions, and these are really simple as well. So I've taken some light blue fondant, rolled it out into a long snake shape, and we're cutting these into equal segments as well. So the first three that I made are called slurps, I believe, and the two smaller ones are called minis, according to my kids anyway. I don't play the game and that's what they tell me. So we're just gonna cap these with some darker blue on our slurps and some lighter gray on the minis. So that was it for the decorations. I wasn't gonna make any more of those, but my little guy told me I absolutely have to make a chug chug. So that's what we're gonna do right now. So I'm rolling out a larger piece of blue fondant and we're gonna cut a little bit off each end so it has more of a cylinder shape. Then we're gonna cap it with a piece of blue and that's our cover. Then I'm gonna roll out a big long piece of gray, nice and thin, so we can add all the strips. So there's gonna be one down each side of our chug chug, and I also am going to do a rim around the top, one right below that, and also one right at the very bottom. And we're just gonna wrap these around and they should stick on there fairly easily on their own, but if they don't, you can add a tiny dab of water to act as a glue so they can stick to it. And now we're just gonna trim away the excess fondant that we don't need, and there you have it, a chug chug to go with the rest of our shield potions. So for our last decoration, we are gonna do our ladder assembly. So all of our little pieces have had lots of time to dry nice and firm, and we're just gonna use tiny dabs of water to stick it all together before finishing it off with some little nail marks by using a tiny little round piping tip. And there we go, it's ready. So it's time for our final coat of icing, and this is just a small fault line around the bottom of our cake using a little bit of green buttercream. And we're just smoothing that out with our bench scraper and going around a couple of times to make sure it is nice and smooth, and then we're going to finish this off with a ring of grass around the base of our cake. And I've used a number 133 grass piping tip to achieve that effect. And we're also going to add some grass to the very top of our cake because we're going to be adding a centerpiece, which we will see in just a moment. So the next thing we're going to do is decide where we want the front of our cake to be. Then we're going to take our Fortnite logo and place it in the front and center, so that way we know exactly how to place the topper on our cake. And as you guys can see, that's right, I made Fish Stick, and he was so much fun to make. And I know he wasn't in the video, but I promise there will be one really soon, so be sure to hit that subscribe button and ring the bell so you don't miss when I post it in the next one. Okay, it's time to finish this up. So we just need to add our personalized flag banner, a ribbon around our cake board to dress it up a little bit, and then we're gonna add a little bit of grass on the side so we have a way to attach the ladder to the side of the cake. And voila, there you have it, guys. Isn't that super cool? I love how this cake turned out. All the decorations were so simple to make, except for Fish Stick. He's a little bit different, but you guys will see that in the next one. So be sure to stay tuned. Hit that like button if you like the video, and don't forget to leave a comment and let us know what you think. And hit that subscribe button and ring that bell, and I will see you on the next one. Thanks for watching, guys. I really hope you love the cake.